A little while ago, I was sent the new XPPen Artist Pro Gen 2 drawing display so that I could test it out and review it for you guys. I've always happily worked with a pretty ancient screenless pen tablet, and I'd never tried a drawing display before, so I was curious what that would be like. I tried it on both my MacBook and my PC. The method for connecting them is a little bit different on each. On the MacBook, you can just plug it in with a USB-C cable. Just make sure on the MacBook that you use the first USB-C port. Then it just works as a second screen. You'll also need to download the XPPen software from their website. On PC, if you don't have a USB-C in port, like my PC, which only has USB-A input ports, you can use a special cable that has an HDMI plug for your graphics card, so you just connect it like you would a second monitor. Except this cable also has an additional USB-A connection that you need to plug into your PC, and another USB-A connection for the power adapter. Luckily, all of these cables come in the box with the drawing display. Also in the box is the pen, of course. By the way, all these things feel very solid and heavy and are made of metal. The pen comes with various extra nibs, which is nice in case one wears out. There's also this little remote pad, which you can either hook up directly with a USB-C cable or with a Bluetooth dongle that it comes with. I think this remote has the potential to make working with the drawing display much more accessible, because it can replace the most used keyboard shortcuts. For example, you could use the ring button to change the brush radius in sculpt mode. Or you could set the other buttons for Alt, Control, Shift, maybe also some mode changes like Sculpt Object Edit Mode, and of course set one for the Quick Favorites menu. You could get pretty far without having your keyboard in the way, which is one of the challenges when working with one of these drawing displays. Speaking of challenges, one of the downsides I found is that when you're using this tablet in a room with a ceiling window or built-in ceiling lights, the reflection on the screen can make it harder to see what you're doing. In that case, I recommend working somewhere else or just turning off those lights. Luckily, this is a pretty portable setup that you can use in combination with your laptop. And if I read it correctly from the manual, you could even plug this into your phone. Practically speaking, in the XPPen software, you can change what the buttons on the pen do. First, you need to add Blender in the app list because the options are set per app. I like to have the nib set as left click and then the lower button as middle mouse so that I can hold it and navigate in the 3D viewport. And then the second button as right click for context menus. At first I thought that the nib can't act as left click because there is no option there, but fortunately it's set as left click by default. With the pen set up this way, you can press the lower button and hover to rotate the view, hold Ctrl to zoom and Shift to pan. And press the second button to right-click and touch the nib on the screen to click or select objects. In the Windows settings under the monitor settings, you can choose to either extend the screens, which means that the tablet works as a second monitor, or to duplicate the screen, which means that your primary monitor and the drawing display will show the same thing. I recommend leaving it set to extend, because otherwise both screens will be scaled the same way, which may not be what you want. After that, you can just drag Blender from your main monitor to the drawing display, which just works as your second monitor. The nice thing about this screen is that the resolution of the screen is pretty high at 2560 by 1600, which is good because it's quite a big screen. And it is very pressure sensitive. Apparently, it has 16,000 pressure levels, which is 15,999 more pressure levels than the mouse I occasionally use to sculpt with. But seriously, it has way more pressure levels than my old graphic tablet, which had a little over 8,000 pressure levels. I think this is probably especially important with organic modeling, like creatures or characters, and for texture painting. I haven't used the XPPen for a long time yet, so I can't say for sure whether it'll replace my current tablet, but I plan to experiment with the extra buttons remote to see if it can be enough to work without a keyboard. That could be a really nice way to work. So I hope this is a helpful video for you to inform you about the use of this kind of drawing display. I personally think this is a very nice one. It has very good colors and sensitivity, and it's easy to use. You just plug it in, download the software, and you're all set. If you want to learn more about XPPen, you can find all the relevant links in the description of this video. Thank you for watching until the end.